So I have these W's that I thought I would speak about. I've jotted them down here because I can't possibly be expected to remember them all because they're rather weird. The first one is who, obviously. And someone asked me about a program which probably hasn't been shown over here, or maybe it has. It's called Who Do You Think You Are? And it's a British program in which you follow your ancestors. Right? Now, the reason I mention this first, although I did actually scribble it down, as I say, completely in random order, so how these things come out is a matter of guesswork, is because it occurred to me that although you are mostly, I suspect, Australians, and I am mostly not, we are very closely related. And it's an odd thing. I'm not a mathematician. There may be mathematicians in the audience, but most of us are probably more literate than we are numerate in this world. It just so happens. And yet we're not stupid. We know what is obviously true. Now, when I was asked by the BBC to do this genealogy program, Who Do You Think You Are?, it's a quite interesting way of doing it because they basically say you've got 2.5 weeks of filming, carry a passport with you at all times, that's it. You don't know anything else. A car comes to pick you up in the morning. For all you know, you're going to fly to South Africa or indeed to Australia or to Central Europe, in my case, for the Jewish side of my family. And you've no idea what you're going to discover. And it's a very exciting thing to do. We would all dream of doing it. It's just wonderful when you've got a broadcasting company who does all the work for you and pays for the genealogists and so on. But I was talking to someone about doing this, and they said, oh, I do envy you. And their surname, for the sake of argument, was Clark. And they said, you know, there have been Clarks in my part of Yorkshire for 300 years. And I thought, what a peculiar thing to say. And I'll tell you why it's peculiar. It's because, as you probably know, our surnames in our culture are based on the surnames of our father, whose surname is based on his father's surname, and so on. But it doesn't take too much for us to recognize that we have 2 parents, 4 grandparents, 8 great-grandparents, 16 great-great-grandparents, 32 great-great-great-grandparents, 64, 128, 256, 512, 1024, 2048, 4096, and so on. And then in a few generations, you have tens of thousands of ancestors, each one of whom is as responsible for your existence as the other. Go back in time and pluck one of them out of history, and you cannot exist. And only one out of 4,096 has that surname that you think is somehow who you are. But who you are is a vast panoply of people. So much so that if any of you has English or indeed Scottish blood in your veins, then you must be related to Henry IV. Because you have more ancestors going back then than the population of Britain. So all I really wanted to say at the outset is hello, brothers and sisters. It's that simple. Anyway,